on the edge of the acetabulum. You can't do that in dysplasia, otherwise you disconnect. Now I'm going anteriorly, and I hope you can see, but you've seen that before, it's exactly the same. We have got anterior wall here, and I'm leaving a 2 millimeter fringe of bone protruding beyond the metal anterior wall. Okay. Cup is done, but cup is not grafted yet, but acetabulum is roared up. So, are there any questions from the United States of America? Shoot, now.
Could you show us the final cup position?
Can I show you the final cup position? Oh, yeah. Well, one screw from a mechanical point of view, folks, is not sufficient. So you have to put the two screws in. There's the defect up there in the false acetabulum. The unsupported acetabular component. And we've launched two neutralization bolts into the pelvis to make up for the lack of bony support. We will later bone graft with morselized graft all that area. We've got support anteriorly, we've got support posteriorly, and we've got support in the floor. And I've gone right down to, as much as I dare, namely the inner table medially. So I would reckon that my inclination is about 35 degrees here, and I would reckon that my antiversion is about 5 to 10 degrees. We are, my colleagues have reviewed a minimum 5-year dysplasia patients, dysplasia resurfacing patients of mine, and did I say there were a minimum 5-year follow-up? Yeah, 5 to 9 year follow-up, and there are 100-something patients, I've forgotten exactly. Joseph around? 110? 110, he tells me. Joseph Daniel tells me 110 patients. And there are no acetabular failures. There are infections, however. Was it 2 or 1 in that series? 1. 1 in that first series. And on the mechanical failure, we had a fractured neck of femur, and we had a collapsed head from soft bone. And that's why I pointed out to you the osteopenia and the lateral aspect of the head. You want to pay attention to how good the bone is, because I have a lady who failed on the femoral side because her bone just crushed. Wasn't strong enough. But not a single cup failure. So it's a pretty powerful device for dealing with dysplasia.
Quick question from Charlotte. Has there any protrusio migration in the dysplastic cups when they're placed against the medial wall?
No. So they wanted to know there, is there medial migration in these cups when they're placed against the medial wall? Absolutely none. I place all the cups against the medial wall, all my total hip cups, all my resurfacing cups. We know on RSA studies with the standard cups that there's 0.2 millimeters of migration in the first 2 months. And from then on out to 5 years, we've published out to 2 years, but we've just completed the study out to 5 years, not published yet, but will be hopefully soon. No migration to 5 years. So these things are stable. They don't move.